I'm Evan, and this is my 2-speed 1-reverse transmission that I put in my mechanical car. The first one will be talking about the gears. This 2-to-1 and 1-to-1 gear ratio design is made by Vladik Kamel, the guy who made the fully mechanical car that transferred the torque from the engine into the wheels. At first, he uses the gear in his 3-speed transmission car that he made in the past. The 2-to-1 gear uses a half cylinder and a normal cylinder. If you want to reduce friction, you can mirror lock these motors and then put some unpowered motors in each cylinder. However, note, by using these motors, the motor could glitch at high speeds due to the centrifugal force made. Not just that, the collision power from the object is also greatly decreased, making the small gear slip even more during heavy accelerations or at high speeds. So I recommend you to use this at a slower car that doesn't change its speed much. The next one, we have 1-to-1 gear ratio. Believe me, every single of my 1-to-1 gear ratio never reaches my expectation, including this one design. This gear uses only cylinders, making it easier to put a motor to each cylinder without a motor lock. However, what I don't like about this gear is that first, you might notice that if you shape every cylinder in the gear, it doesn't make a perfect circle compared to the other gear designs, making the output speed unstable considering the different gear diameters. Second is that this gear makes a sudden RPM freeze a lot of times. It could either be during heavy accelerations or just when moving the car normally. This sudden RPM freeze happens once again due to the imperfect gear design, like for example, too many gaps between cylinders and other things. At least even if the RPM stops quite a lot of time, it still increases the car speed around 10 speeds. Now for the last gear, the reverse gear. This is where people might wonder, how could my reverse gear is faster than any other gears, decreasing the speed from gear 2 to reverse around 20, which means an insane 18 speed in total. If you ask me how is it possible, the first and reverse gear uses two objects, making contact with each other. Combined with roadblocks, physics and friction, then it will slow down the top speed or the power made by the engine. As for the reverse gear, it doesn't need any object making contact. Instead, it uses three motors connectors with a tag. This is the mechanism similar to a real-life transmission. Other gears like gear 1 and gear 2 is not connected every time, and then you could easily connect the gears. As for reverse, this motor connector is always connected, making the reverse gear spins even at first or second gear. The sliding mechanism. To change between different gear ratios to make a different torque and speed, the gear slides each other using a piston that pushes the red half wedge. As I said before, in real life all the gears is already connected or making contact with each other. Then it uses the gear selector fork to connect each gear output into the transmission output. As for my transmission, it's the gear that slides each other. Instead of the gear's connectors, this is used to greatly reduce friction made by the gears. Not just that, it also saves some space in the car. The 1-to-1 gear design is not the best at friction as well, so by doing so, it helps save some power. In order to switch gears or apply a gear, the system is similar like in real life. First, you need to detach the clutch, press key 1 to switch to gear 1. Give the engine some power, then finally attach the clutch again. This is because if you were about to attach the clutch first, then you change to gear 1, the gear won't be able to change because it doesn't have enough time to go backwards before the next cylinder hits the output to apply gear 1. By detaching the clutch, the cylinder of the gear could move backwards freely without interruptions of other cylinders. The same also happens when changing from gear 1 to gear 2. To change from gear 1 to gear 2, it's a little bit different than applying gear 1 when the car first accelerates. First, you need to press key 2. This is used so that the gear 2 is always prepared to push backwards at any time. After that, press 1 to detach gear 1, then quickly press key F to detach the clutch. Note that this clutch works in toggle mode, which means if you press once, it detaches. Press once again, it connects. After gear 2 is connected, quickly as you can to press key F again to attach the clutch, then that's it, you're on gear 2. The reverse gear is designed to only work when the car is stopped or when the car is at slow speeds. In fact, it's doing so by accident while designing it. To switch the reverse gear, there's just two eye cylinders for the connectors to attach it to the output. When the engine is at high speeds or when attached to gear 1 or gear 2, these two cylinders won't be able to match its speed and resulting the reverse won't connect. This also applies in real life. When you're still going forward, you cannot apply this reverse gear until the car has come into a slow speed or a full stop. However, in real life it won't be controlled by other things that I haven't discovered yet. You might also notice these cylinders here. What's its purpose? If I were about to switch gears using another unpowered motors, the rotation will slow down a lot. Some of you might not know that when you're about to connect two unpowered motors in one axis, that rotation will be much slower rather than connecting it with just one unpowered motor to the same object that's physically or non-physically connected. For example, take a look at this crankshaft, then I will put two rockets which represents the power of the pistons. This crankshaft got two unpowered motors to hold themselves. Then I will try to power the crankshaft and see what happens. The rotation is not as fast as I'm hoping to be. Now I will delete one unpowered motor and see what happens. As expected, the rotation is way faster than before, which is perfect for high speed cars like my Ferrari FXX or other cars. However, note this effect only applies when you connected it directly or when using the suspension or a piston. If you use, like for example, universal joints, then connect it with two unpowered motor in the input and output, then the double unpowered motor effect won't apply to the rotation. This is why I use these cylinders to switch between gears. As for the other side of the gear, it uses these big cylinders which acts like the gear holder to hold itself in place. And that's it for today's video on how this transmission works. I decided to put this video separated from the mechanical car video, especially this transmission, because the transmission took a while to explain. Stay tuned for part 2 of how my mechanical car works, and see you next time.